Step 4. Gel purification of vector and insert. During the gel purification, we are going to load the PCR fragment and the digested vector on an agarose gel, apply electric current, and separate DNA molecule based on their molecular weight. Then we will cut out DNA bands from the agarose and clean them with a gel purification kit. The summary of gel purification protocol is presented here on the screen. The advantage of running vector restriction digest in parallel with PCR is that they both will be ready about the same time for gel purification. This way, we can run both vector and insert on the same agarose gel. Let's prepare a 1% agarose gel. I'm going to weigh 2 grams of agarose. And add them to 200 milliliters of the TAE buffer. Then I heat it in the microwave until it boils. A safety note, please wear heat protective gloves when you handle a bottle with boiling agarose. Also, leave the screw cap on the bottle somewhat loose to allow for vapors to vent. Then I let the agarose to cool down for 15 minutes. Add ethidium bromide. And swirl the bottle to mix up ethidium bromide. Another safety note, please remember that ethidium bromide is cancerogen and change your gloves each time when you get in contact with gels, trays, or any other contaminated equipment. Now I'm going to pour the agarose in a tray with a comb. And let it solidify for 30 minutes. Finally, I'm going to transfer the gel into a running tray filled with TAE buffer. By now, both vector restriction digest and the PCR are ready. So on the agarose gel, I'm going to run 1 microliter of molecular weight marker, 1 microliter of uncut vector, entire vector restriction digest, and all 50 microliters of PCR reaction. To each of these tubes, I have already added loading dye, which contains bromophenol blue and glycerol. I am back to the gel room with my tubes and I am ready to load the gel. Once again, molecular weight marker, uncut plasmid, cut plasmid, and PCR product. I will run this gel until the bromophenol blue dye reaches the end, which at the current settings is 35 minutes at 105 volts. The run is over. Let's take the gel to a UV transilluminator and have a look at it. Here is our DNA separated on the agarose gel. Let me put the labels here. In the left lane we have the marker, then uncut vector, cut vector, and the PCR product. There are a few pieces of information that I extract from this kind of picture. First of all, I compare uncut and cut vector lanes. You see how the entire vector band shifted up. This means that the vector was linearized. I also look at the molecular weight of the linearized vector and compare it with information from the sequence file. The size of PSAT6 MCS is supposed to be 3,900 base pairs, which is in agreement with what I see on the gel. In addition, I roughly estimate the amount of vector DNA. The rule of thumb is that if you can see it well on the gel, then you should have sufficient amount for efficient ligation. In the case of the PCR product, I also look at the molecular weight and the amount of DNA. Right now, everything looks great, so I will proceed with cutting out the vector and the PCR fragment from the gel. Before cutting the gel, I prepared two labeled Eppendorf tubes, two razor blades, and a UV shield. Now I'm going to put the UV shield on, pull out transilluminator from the imaging system, and turn on the UV light. Cutting gel is pretty straightforward. I usually cut off the gel to the left of my band. Then to the right. Then to the top. And the bottom. Then I pick a gel fragment with a razor blade and transfer it to a labeled tube. The same about the PCR band. I cut it out. And transfer to an Eppendorf tube. Now I'm going to use gel purification kit to extract DNA from the gel. If you have used gel purification kits before, please fast forward to the next step. The GFX gel band purification kit I have here on the bench comes from GE Healthcare. It consists of GFX DNA binding columns, a capture buffer, and a wash buffer with ethanol. I start gel purification by weighing my gel bands. Then I add equal amount of capture buffer. To dissolve the agarose, I incubate the tubes at 65 degrees for 10 minutes. Then I transfer the solutions with dissolved agarose to the GFX columns. I spin the columns for 30 seconds in a microcentrifuge. Then I discard the flow through and add 500 microliters of the wash buffer. I spin the columns again. Then I place the columns into the new tubes and elute DNA by adding 50 microliters of double distilled water. Finally, I do one last spin in the centrifuge. At the end of the step, our vector is cut, cleaned, and ready for ligation. The PCR product still has to be cut with ZO and BUM H1.